What's up, y'all? This your girl, Go Mal. I am going to do a start the series again of Ask Go Mal, and here is some of the questions, just some random questions that you guys have been asking me, or some questions I done seen on the internet that I think I may can answer or take a shot at answering, or we all can answer this together. Y'all comment down below if y'all think of some other answers to the questions that I may post. So we're going to go ahead and answer this question now, so let's get it in, you guys. Okay, so the question that I had got, y'all have to excuse me, Nivea over there on the sidelines. Nivea, you want to come say hi?
No.
No? I wasn't expecting that, but she said no. She don't know what no means, y'all. She just says no and whatever. So, anyways, the question that I received, or what I saw online, is my sister got her hair text-laxed, but her hair is still straight. I think that was something that somebody posted on one of my videos. I don't know. Child, I don't know if it was. Thank you for the question. So, it was like, why is her hair still straight? Pretty much. Okay, if she, more than likely, if somebody is getting their hair text-laxed, trying to get their hair text last. What I think now, I'm going to just tell y'all my two cents. If y'all want to chime in, feel free to chime in below. But as far as text lax goes, if you go to a salon, and I mean a salon, a professional salon, and you ask them to get your to text lax your hair, I don't honestly think it's something that they specialize in, unless you might have to pick one that specializes in text-laxing hair, because most salons who applies relaxer, who puts relaxer in your head, is going to go for the more straighter look, because that's just pretty much how it goes. That's what a relaxer is intended to do, is to straighten your hair, to loosen your curl pattern. And so in most cases, if you go to a salon, their goal is going to be to get your hair straight, whether if it's bone straight or mostly straight or close to bone straight, it's going to be straight. I would say leaving having your hair text-laxed and not leaving the relaxer in as long as you should, and not smoothing your hair out to make it straighter like you're supposed to, as what we was taught in cosmetology school. I say we and myself, because you guys know I'm a licensed cosmetologist. I don't know everything, but I try to know as much as I can. But as far as what we was taught and how we all think in our brain is, being at a salon, we was not taught to leave the relaxer in a little bit and then take it right back out real quick, and then it don't relax your hair as straight as the person who doing your hair wanted to be at a salon, because we was taught to make your hair straight, not text lax. So text lax for a person at a salon, the owner or whoever work in the salon, it means your hair is under process to them, and it means that they did not do a good job relaxing your hair. Okay, nowadays, 2018, a lot of people want their hair under process. A lot of people want their hair with the text lax look that leaves texture in your hair. So if you go to a salon to get your hair text lax, you might want to go to a salon who, if there's any salons out there that specializes in text laxing hair, I don't know if there is. I think this whole text lax thing started on YouTube. From my knowledge, I'm not sure. If y'all want to chime in below, go ahead, feel free. But I think the whole under processing hair started with like a YouTube trend. So in a salon, if you go to a salon, that's not their thing to text lax your hair, because they want your hair leaving straight and beautiful. Because at the end of the day, you know, back in the day before all this text lax and natural movement came about, if your hair was still had curls in it of some sort, if you still had texture in your hair after getting a fresh relaxer, then whoever did your relaxer did it wrong. They didn't do a good job. That's what was said back then. They didn't do a good job, or your relaxer didn't take good, girl. You need to find somebody else to do your hair. Your relaxer didn't take good, girl. You should have left it in a little bit longer. You know, your relaxer didn't take good. You should have smoothed it out a little bit more and leave it on a little bit longer. But that's just how it go, you know. And for that person that's in the salon, they don't want to have a bad name as the person that didn't put their relaxer in good, put the other person relaxer in good. So if you go to a salon, they're going to try to give you professional results, which is straightening your hair and make your hair as straight and pretty as it can be and flow it and wave it and bounce it and all of that with the straight look, okay? So that's just my take on these professionals in a salon. I'm not talking down on a professional because, y'all, I'm one myself. I might not be in a salon, but I am one. I know enough, you know? But that's how I feel like they feel, because if it was me and my salon, which I used to have back in Florida, if I was to, back in the day when we used to do relaxers, if that relaxer didn't take good in that made that salon person, whoever did your hair, that made them look bad, because in our eyes we thought, oh, our hair was supposed to be straight when you put the relaxer in, but it really don't supposed to be straight. It don't supposed to be bone straight. It's supposed to be straight to a certain extent, but bone straight, no. But leaving texture in as well, no. You're not supposed to leave a whole lot of texture in it either, in order for the relaxer to be so-called done correctly. You're supposed to knock those curls out of that hair, you know, not bone straight, but straight enough that you don't got no curls left, but you might have a little wavy pattern left. That's all. You're supposed to have a little slight wave in it, but not straight. They don't want to have to be over processed at the same time, because if your hair's still bone straight when you wet it and you relax, then your hair's most likely over processed. But if that's what you like, then that's on you. But some people like their hair to be bone straight, some people like their hair to be just right, which is your relaxer took just right, with enough wave in your hair to still be not over processed. But Texlax, on the other hand, is leaving a whole lot of texture in your hair with a whole lot of waves, but not as curly as your natural hair. You know, you want to knock that natural hair curl pattern down a notch. That's what Texlaxing is. You leave it on enough to knock your natural curl pattern down, but not enough to have it fully relaxed where your wave is like a slight wave, and not, definitely not bone straight. Then that's over processed. So at the salon, 9 times out of 10, you're going to get your hair processed just right, not over processed, not under processed. So at the end of the day, if you want your hair Texlax, you might want to talk to your stylist before even attempting to Texlax your hair. They have to know exactly what they're doing. And then 9 times out of 10, if you start getting your hair Texlax in a salon, that same person who Texlax your hair need to be the same person who Texlax your hair every time, because Texlaxing is so confusing, man, because you can over process it real easy by leaving the relaxer on too long, or by not feeling through the hair as much as you need to see how smooth it is or how curly it is. It's a tricky process, you know. So if your salon person ain't with the Texlaxing movement, then and you want to be Texlax, I recommend you either talk to them and see if they know how to start it, or they got it, or they already done did it. They have some experience in it, because Texlaxing is a whole different world, because you can end up with a bunch of different curl patterns if you don't Texlax it right every single time. And I have some spots in my hair which are not over processed, but processed enough to not be Texlax, and I'm still working on those spots. But at the same time, my hair is mostly Texlax now, especially once I cut off my ends and all of that stuff. I'm still Texlax underneath, and I probably don't even get another relaxer probably once or maybe twice a year. I don't know. I'm lying. I don't even know. We cross that bridge when we get to it. And I don't need no Nazis coming for me. Please don't come for me, because, you know, whatever. So I was just coming to answer that question and to let you guys know that Texlaxing is a very confusing process. So if you want a professional to Texlax your hair, you're going to need to tell them that's what you want first. And then not only tell them that's what you want, see if they know how to do it. You know, and because a lot of people, a lot of professionals in a salon, they already trained to relax your hair properly. properly. When I say properly, that's not Tex-Lax, that's not over process, that's just right. So if they salon trained to already do that, then that's what they do. They didn't do the relaxer wrong because they didn't Tex-Lax you right, they did the relaxer right. So that's what a relaxer is meant to be done properly. Tex-Laxing is not putting the relaxer in properly, okay? Putting it in wrong, pretty much. And you're putting it in right, but you're not leaving it on long enough, so you're actually doing it wrong in a lot of people's books. So at the end of the day, if you want your hair Tex-Lax, you need to either get somebody who know how to do it, attempt to do it yourself if you that brave, or talk to your stylist in your salon and make sure she know, she or he know what they're doing before they attempt to Tex-Lax your hair, because Tex-Laxing can go a bunch of ways. It could be you won't get it right every single time that you Tex-Lax it, but once you get used to that same head of hair you Tex-Laxing over and over again, you'll pretty much learn that person's hair, because it's the whole process. It's like transitioning to natural. If you've never been Tex-Lax and you relax and you want to get Tex-Lax, it's almost like transitioning to natural, but in a Tex-Lax form. Y'all, I can't explain it. If anybody want to break it down a little bit more for the people back there in the back to hear, y'all feel free to comment below and let me know what you guys think. Y'all, thank you guys for these questions. I appreciate them. If y'all got any more questions, feel free to ask me anything, okay? Thank you guys so much for watching, and that's all I got to say in this video, and I will holla at y'all later. Bye.